Go slow, concentrate on what you're doing. Hey, what's up?
How you doing? It's been a long time.
Week or so, and the week before that, he went to Monte with his cousins, and my wife was in Manila, so he had 2 weeks off. Now he's got to get back to work.
Yeah.
He's playing the Rancho Monthly Metal this weekend.
This weekend?
Yeah. Sunday he has a tournament, so I'm going to Samoa this weekend, so it's crazy. Going to Cagayan next week. Slow down, boy.
I got my power down.
Okay, of course. They're working on your air conditioning, huh?
Yeah, the air conditioning. You wanted to make the base more relaxed.
All the walls. the glass up?
Yeah.
Long of a backswing. Just going a little long. Nothing wrong with the swing. Shorten. There you go. Crying about something. Construction over here is out of control. Yeah. Down the road that way.
Yeah. Oh yeah, the road.
Yeah, it's bad.
That's really bad.
It's almost. Maybe 5 minutes away from instead going around.
Yeah.
It might be faster. It's 5 minutes. Take your break. Come out of the sun. Sit on that one so you don't mess with the camera. Or sit, don't touch the table. Sit there. So you don't shake the camera.
Put the dirty clothes.
Yep. I told you don't hit the table. What's wrong with you? Just sit and relax.
Not bad.
very good amateur or he's a local pro.
The reporter was here the other day.
He has lots of spin.
There are pro golfers.
Oh yeah, there is. The pro tour is here now.
Yeah.
They played Rancho last week. They're playing Apple this week.
Yeah.
All the professionals are here.
All the professionals are here?
Yeah, they're in Davao. Last week they had a big tournament at Rancho. This week they're at Apple playing another tournament.
Oh yeah, the Pro-Am.
Yeah.
I think those were Koreans, Korean pros, or mm-hmm. Japanese.
Yeah. But they're going to play the Philippine tour.
Yeah. Tell him about the Chinese guy.
What?
Matsuyama.
Matsuyama? No, he's on the PGA, buddy.
No, I told him.
No.
He's this guy who takes... He's the Chinese guy?
Japanese.
He's on the Japanese guy who takes his way, like... Pause 3 seconds.
That's quite a long pause.
And he hits it like a mile.
Like a mile?
Yeah, he...
That's a long way.
Right, Dad?
Yeah.
He's...
Very slow backswing.
Boom! Then he just fires.
Barkley's downswing. Awesome.
They have a pretty low Shaq now.
Yeah, Shaq. I think Shaq has a better swing than Charles.
How long have you just taken him to... Controlling your distance is everything.
Well, it looks like he's controlling his distance.
He knows. Only he knows. Alright, get back to it, boy. Same club.
Oh.
We're chipping. Finish that box to the 10 yard. She doesn't want to get dark. Philippine, well, you're dark no matter what, so. Filipinos don't want to get any darker.
Yeah, like Americans, they like the tan.
Yeah, it's the opposite.
Yeah, the opposite.
Filipinos provide some skin white and green. But it doesn't work.
Yeah, which doesn't work.
It's right along the road. They do have commercials for making your skin white.
And taking away pimples.
Yeah, but that works. The skin whitening doesn't work. It's all a big scandal. Keep everything good. Keep your thumb where it's supposed to be. lazy. Take it back slow and turn. Hit the ground first. That means your hips didn't move at all. Just deep. Take it back and turn it through. Slow down. Think about, imagine that's your landing spot on the green. You're going to land it there and it's going to roll. That would have rolled off the green, you're right. Got the distance right, you just didn't hit it good. You don't fix it like that. You fix it by doing everything right. There you go. Takes a lot of practice. He has to play in the... semifinals of the Augusta Drag Championship.
Not really. Still got three goals. Yeah, Mega Man.
So it's not that bad.
Yeah, it's not that bad. It's work, really.
Playing Mega Man on the computer is pretty good.
3/4 9 better.
Told you. Look at my children.
Thank you.
turn.
I
You just start that? Concentrate and think about every shot. Think about that pin being on the uphill slope. That's where you gotta land it.
Concentrate on everything.
Slow takeaway. Good. Feel the balance? That's the hands flip by themselves. Turn those hands back to the ball. Don't get outside your foot. Yeah. You're making a big bump move on a little swing. It's not that big on the board. Down, your wrists are going to release. I want that straight, keep it dropping. Drop it right on top of the ball. Okay. Stay down. Come on, I'm going to show you. There's only one way you have to stay.
Take that face off, or you're all acting in your face. You're going to get your
work in, whether you like me or not. Somewhere out here when you're hitting the ball. Already your belt buckle needs to be out there before you hit the ball. That's not bad. That's better than left. Because that's it's supposed to start that way and come back with a draw, right?
Yeah.
So once it starts going out there and not going here, but out there and slowly, then you're closer. Hard left is bad, hard right is bad. Out there a little bit and drawing, pretty close. Quick. Fast. You have to allow the things in the golf swing to happen by themselves and not force them to happen. There you go. It's a little overdrawn, but not bad.
Yeah, not bad.
It's the right shot shape, right? It's the right shape. It's a little high, so it means you chopped a little bit coming down, but it's close. Doesn't look as pretty, it's a better strike than the last one. You stay in on
it. Is it supposed to slide on the mat? Or where's the perfect
pin? With an iron.
Yes.
And then as you release, that gives you a shot.
So they're supposed to be a parent.
Yeah, it's in a perfect world. It's supposed to go out.
I'm going to the 2 yard there. It'll go to the 10 yard line.
And you turn that around because I'm fixing that spin on the ball, right?
Right.
That's the inside spin. Get the back spin from the downward motion. Get the front spin from the wrist. Doing what it does, right? You come through and nothing happens. So your swing is really here. This plane, right? Across here. So you're coming from here. And driving through. The ball starts going there. And it comes back around. You're trying to make it go this line. That's never going to work. That's not the way your body goes. People think that's the way you're supposed to go. But it's really up. Down. Look at the club head only. Comes from in there. It doesn't come straight back down the line, right? Maybe a little chip or something like that comes from there. It's always coming from the inside to the outside.
Inside, outside.
Yeah, so it's in here. And I actually that way. Because when you set up letting it go, sequence power is not a problem because the club will do all the work for you, right?
Yeah.
That's the trick. Mm-hmm. Okay, go back there again. Up. Now, when you bump, when your weight goes that way, only let the lower body go that way. Keep this back. There. And then you turn the hip, and it turns everything. See, because these can never catch up to your belt buckle. So in essence, you go up, and it's like this, grab your belt buckle, the hands stay way back here. That's where the power is, right?
Yeah.
Lag.
Lag.
Must have lag.
Lag.
No arms.
Arm.
Closer. Timing was bad, but closer.
Yeah.
You release it. Your hip all the way through before you hit the ball, which is the right order of things. Closer again. And they call it the setup because you're setting up that way, that's where you want them to turn to, so don't change it. That one, right when you came down, you're back right. Before you hit it. The elbows, the hands go through, the face opens.
Balik mo ano? Ano ala ba balik mo?
You have to stay here. And when you look out there, now when you're watching your ball, you're watching it this way. Okay, then come on. You know? So that's where the physicality of golf comes in, right? So you have this angle on your back right now. It should stay on that angle, right? It shouldn't raise up. And there goes a straight ball. You see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I mean, you didn't hit it completely solid, but it went in the right path, the right height. It's just, it's so many little things.
Yeah, so many little things.
That's why he does this over and over and over. He's just practicing everything. When it comes down to grip and setup, once you have your grip set up, you can do it the same way every single time. Now can you turn your chest back the same way? Now can you move your hip the same every time?
Now can you let this go?
Now can you, it's all built on, it's like a pyramid, right?
Yeah.
You can't do this piece until you have this piece mastered. And every now and then you'll get lucky and you'll hit it perfect and you're like, oh man, I got it in me. Can I do it that way all the time? That's where this is.
It's all about consistency.
Yes. Over and over and over.
That's what I do every day.
Yep. Oh, this is not bad. And the reason it's just going so high is just so you can hear, it's hitting the mat first.
Yes, hitting the mat first.
Yeah. So take it up slow to the top. Come up slow and then here. you done bump eye surgery before? You're good? See this L? Keep that L as the hands drop. Keep it. Now turn your hip. Then you let it go. So the hands have to get back in front of the ball, and then you can drop it. If you drop it here, it's going to go down there, right? So if you're prepared to just do that. So. Now if you come down here, and you say, okay, I'm done, you hit there.
Yeah.
And then you try
it. Let it go here, you hit there. So you have to, when you hit left, you have to hold that, and the boom, right on top of the ball, right? So you're not trying to hit up at it, you're hitting down at it. Driving the ball into the mat. That one you hit here.
Yeah.
Yeah. That one was it, and that's quick.
It's neat.
Yeah, well, it's you get back and you're like, okay, swing. And so when you tell yourself, when your brain says that, this is what happens. The hands do nothing but hold the ball
still.
Yeah. The hands literally, my coach always told me, they do nothing. You grip it, but that's it. Everything else has nothing to do with the hands. You turn the chest, and all that happens without using your hands at all. The less hands you have, the more consistent you're going to be, right? Turn it back. It's the right shape, so you're making the right move, which is your release point, right? So what you have to do is you have to slow it down. In order to get that consistency, you have to slow it down and maybe tell yourself, I'm only going to hit this one 80% of my power, right? Slow it down so you can really feel going. Right on top of the ball. And what we do on a grass range, this is a good drill, is you can put a tee here, a broken tee, in the ground about this high, and tell your brain that you're supposed to hit that tee after you hit the ball. Meaning that you got to be way over here and hitting down, not hitting up, right? Yeah. So do this one half speed or something. You hit the ball first.
Yeah.
You see what I'm saying? So you have to slow it down to where your brain can... Remember, there's a lot of things going on here.
Yeah.
And your brain is a supercomputer, but it needs time to process, right? So... Yeah. So you have to allow that brain's computer to do its work. If you go quick, there's no time.
You have to block the mirror.
Yeah, a supercomputer wouldn't even have time to do all this stuff. So give it some time and relax. I mean, you see those effortless swings that you see. But it's all in order and the right angles and all of that. So power is generated not by force, but by motion, right? Doing everything in the right order. That's a mental thing for you to think about, you know what I'm saying? So that 80% should just be a normal swing. 80%. Ball first 2 times in a row. See what I'm saying? And it's going farther.
Yeah.
You're not hitting it perfect yet, you're still getting a little thin. So that means you're, instead of hitting it here on the second or third, you're getting it down in here still. Because you're pulling up just the hair. The angle a little better, and you get that same tempo, and it starts to drop a little farther the club. And then you get the sweet spot, and then it just launches by itself. And we call that effortless power. So you don't have to try hard to generate power, you just have to get it right. That one, you went a little quicker. You feel it?
Yeah.
And you hit this far behind the ball again.
Yeah.
So when you go, see, the hands are a twitch muscle. They're very good at doing little things. They do it very quickly. In golf, we don't want that very quick little thing. We need big muscles to control it, right? So we use the chest, and we use the hips. We don't ever let these guys be twitchy, because they do things we can't control them, right? No good. So turn it back. So try to think about your hands being very quiet. You're not going to do a lot of work. Just return your chest. Not bad.
Yeah, not bad.
See what I'm saying? It's all here too. So it's not only this, it's how you perceive. If you're like, I'm going to hit it, forget it, you're dead. You know what I mean? You can't ever have that day. Because you could be right here, everything good for you, you don't go. You're toast.
Yeah.
Your brain's going to take over. Your hands are like, I got this! But
like, I'm trying to get a toast out of it.
understood the Matrix. The whole point of it was that he was the one, but he had to believe he was the one before he could be the one. He was the one, but he couldn't do anything until he believed, he really believed. And it took him those trials and errors before he believed. This is exactly the same thing. You can't believe that there's power in you until you learn it by yourself. I can tell you a gazillion times in a row, the crow can come over and tell you a million times in a row, until you do it over and over and over. Do you believe it? You know? It is what it is. It's practice.
Yeah.
It's over and over and over. It takes years. I mean, the crows used to come in here, they've been doing it for 20 years. That's what they do. That's why it's simple. Right? I mean, you can imagine those, I don't know if you've ever seen, they have those crazy people over in the Middle East that like to drive on two wheels on their cars and all this stupid stuff. But they didn't just say, okay, I'm going to drive, donk, and get on two wheels, and they had to sit and practice that over and over. You can't do it. It's too hard, right? Nobody can just pick it up and know how to do it.
Yeah, I love it.
So it takes, I mean, Matthew's been playing tournaments solid for a year, and he's already been swinging a golf club for 3 years. And I've been doing it for almost 10 years. And my coach has been doing it for 40 years.
40 years?
Yeah, so I mean, he's been doing it since he was a kid.
You know, the famous, one famous PGA coach was here once. His name is Chris Hinton. He was here once, but I never got to have lessons with him. I think it's pretty good.
Well, I think until you get to a sub-10 handicap, basically any golf coach can help anybody. It's their eyes. They're watching what you do and you can't see it, right? So it doesn't really matter at that point until you get to that level where you need a really good guy or something like that, you know? It depends on, some people never get to single digit handicap. It's hard.
That's right.
It's not hard. Any stretch of the imagination. I played it twice with two different swings and it's freaking hard. It's bad.
It's bad?
It's not only being able to hit the ball. You can come out here and be a range pro and be on a golf course and shoot 100.
Yes.
It's a whole other world,
it's
right?
Whole
so they're in balance.
That's why it's more preferable to play the grass.
Well, great. That's why I can't. If it wasn't was raining, I wouldn't be, you know, down there. It's a completely different feel to the swing, right? But when you're just working on your moves, it's more than acceptable. When you're working on ball striking, then you're concentrating. Then, you need to be on the surface to practice it. That'll help you with your practice is if you just think about, like right there, maybe that tree, and you just think about taking a swing that's about this long.
Right?
Don't worry about all the full stuff, that's called a three-quarter swing. And we use it every time. We have half, we have a thigh, right past the thigh, we have half, three-quarter, full. The pros on tour have 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, you know what I mean, on the clock.
Yeah,
they know every little spot and how far it goes, right? So this one, you can just get here and then work on that move without any notion in your brain of, I got it here. Or I'm trying to hit it far, you're just trying to make a swing at that point. Working on your moves, right? So it takes away the thought in your brain of, I have to hit it. Just working on something in practice. Like a big chip shot, you know what I'm saying? It's not good, you're just going to work on that. Changes your thought pattern a little bit. What you want to concentrate on is leaving your nose behind the ball at all times. When it goes in front, that's when the hands have to start doing helping. If it stays behind, they can swing by themselves, right? So if you set up your nose right in here and leave it there as you swing, so that one was right, you stayed back, and then you let that L disappear. And you have to hold the club up in the air, the face of the club up in the air. So when you come in, it has to stay, pick it up, and remember it's here. You hold up in the air.
So like, radio.
Yeah, do you have to sit right here? And let it stay there. On the ball.
Yeah.
Instead of behind it. And you do it right sometimes, obviously. But you don't know why you do it right sometimes. That's,
yeah.
And that's why. You're letting it release early. You're letting it fall to the ground early. Let it fall to the ground over here. This is where you're going to hit the ground after the ball's gone, right? And in order to do that, you can't do this because it's going to go up again. So you have to hold it, then let it go past it. There you go. And the hands just kind of go in front of your body, right? Like you can pick it up here. And you're like, okay, now I drop it instead of here. Hold it, drop it. Closer. And that's where the ground comes in. For that kind of practice, that's where the ground comes in. Really good help because you can see where you hit it every time. You know what I'm saying? Here you're like, oh, where did I hit it? You have no idea. I'm only knowing because I'm watching right where it hits at, you know? So it's difficult to tell there. That time it was close. It made a different sound. You might be this far behind the ball. You want to click? Then thud, not thud, click. Click the ball, then the ground, right? That was pretty good. And it sounded different, and it flew a little different.
Yeah.
That's what it comes down to, is your hand-eye coordination. Now, can I drop that in the spot that I want to drop it? Get another club. Get your eight. I went 10 three quarters on the green in a row. Yeah, why not?
Eight? Yeah. On the green, but it's too far.
No, the nine is just short.
Oh.
So give me 10, whatever. 10 three-quarter eights on that green in a row. Why not? I can do it. I can do it with my eyes closed. There's one. I didn't say where on the green. On the green. So
shot.
Concentrate on your setup. Your aim's left, so you know. Yeah. Uh-oh, that might not make it. Oh, barely. I don't want to see that one again, huh? Super flexible and limber. They're around here, out here when they hit it. Normal people, that's not flexible enough, right?
I keep turning my head so more than three quarter, it's going over. Just my head.
Let me see if it's really three quarter enough. Fix your sticks so they're straight. Your feet aren't the same as the orange sticks. All right, let's see. Why are you on top of the club? Get your hand down below the white. Bow. Your feet aren't the same as the black stick. Hip and shoulder. Now, give me a three-quarter slow turn and let it go.
You know when you see those PGA players?
Choke down a little bit.
Yeah. It's like a batch of grass.
Don't change anything, just choke down and make the normal swing. That's when you'll start to see, you'll get a revelation.
Oh, that's where,
and you'll see the ball come down, it rolls up the face in slow motion, main shot top, right? The ball only stays on the face for a split second, but during that time, it rolls up two or three moves on the floor. Here you go. So it stays there, and in order for it to stay there, you have to be getting down into it.
I try to keep going.
Oh, you missed your 10. Start over. 10 again.
No, I mean I missed. I kept going when I was still tired.
When you were still tired? Okay.
I kept wanting to.
How long?
Huh?
5 minutes? Lima. Drink water. You have, look, how much water is that bottle? You haven't drank anything. Yeah, you can always tell that way. The grass will tell you. Yep.
So an easy way to tell what the problem is.
Every sport on the planet almost, and it's the hardest
sport ever. Yeah,
golf. It's to be good at, you know what I mean? Anybody can in a year go out and shoot a 90 or something, you know, but shoot 70 is another book.
He's hit millions of balls and he still shoots balls.
Well, you have to not make mistakes.
Back then, he shot millions of balls, and he had to practice for like 3 or 4 years, and he's still shooting balls. All because he has a good short game.
That's why?
Yeah.
That's the secret? Oh,
free
right
bucket.
In the 50. Free bucket.
Do it in.
Even though he already gets free buckets from your baby.
Oh, yeah, you got a free box?
He gets free
but
box.
But useless.
Irrelevant.
I'm going to get that free bucket. You want that?
Yeah.
You want that?
Yeah.
You need it.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. You're going to take it. You got a lot of work to do. Otherwise, even if it was blowing 20 kilometers left to right,
you could still
make it go straight. Because if you hit a draw, you would counteract the wind and just go straight. But when you hold on a hair, if you give a little bit of spin to go with the wind, it's going even further, right?
Dad, as soon as I pretend to put on my gloves, she goes walking.
Doing her job. That was a good one too. Get ball first.
Yeah.
And that's what it takes. Over that move over and over and over until you're like, okay, now 90% of the time I hit the ball first. Now let's work on the other thing. You know? And you're also packed. You gotta remember that even that little swing, it's your big swing. It's only the bottom part of it. If you're practicing the big swing, you're just not making it. Right? So even if you do this move really big and do all of this, if you do this, you're still making the same move. You're just only concentrating on one little piece of it. Which is where beginners learn. They learn to chip, they learn to putt, then they learn a half swing, a three quarter, then a full. Can't do a full if you can't do a half. Another good one. Your brain's starting to learn. You'd be on the golf course and you see Rory or anybody hitting a horrible drive. The next drive, they know exactly what they did wrong and they need to do it the next one.
Daddy.
Just because they know this one that well. Thousands.
Oh, come on. I always forget what I'm going to say because I keep waiting for you.
And the ball's going farther now.
Quite easy control.
Mm-hmm.
What
is there? Oh, yeah.
How is that even possible?
I don't know what I was talking about.
Sitting on the ground. That's how it's
blocking. Oh, I see.
Oh. All right, let me see. Yeah. Come on. You're going to miss your lunch if you don't hurry up and put it.
No, it's going to.
Your mommy.
Oh, we'll
get to
check
your messages.
Yeah, she did. I don't think she was
working. She's at the doctor. All right, get serious now, huh? Give me 10 in a row, three-quarter eights with a choke down.
Oh, yes.
Choke down, hips and shoulder. Concentrate like you're on the golf course.
right. You just have to fire your hips. Your chest flat. Get up. Quit on this machine. There you go. There's nothing wrong with that. It's you. Effort. Go down the proper distance. Get set up, bow, do all your stuff. And put your body in the right spot. Good shoulder.
pinapidala ni Astro.
Thank you. Are you really